If you took CS 101, you saw the idea of memoization. If you haven't seen it, the idea is that sometimes, particularly with a recursive function, you will be making the same function calls over and over again. If the result of a function call is always the same and the computation took a long time, it's better to store the results of each value of n with its result in a cache, a table data structure, and then look it up each time rather than try to recompute it. We can make this function be cached very simply with a couple extra lines of code. We asked, if the argument is already in the cache, then we just go ahead and return it. Otherwise, we compute it, store it, and then return it. And so this part with the dot, dot, dot is the body of the function. All the rest is just the kind of boilerplate that you have to do to implement this idea of a cache. We've done this once, and that's fine, but I'm worrying about the principle of don't repeat yourself. There's probably going to be lots of functions in which I want to store intermediate results in a cache, and I don't want to have to repeat this code all the time. And so this is a great idea for a decorator. We can define a decorator called memo, which will go ahead and do this cache management, and we can apply it to any function. And the great thing about this pattern of using memoization is that it will speed up any function f that you pass to it, because doing a table lookup is going to be faster than a computation, as long as the computation is non-trivial, is more than just a lookup. Now, the hockey player Wayne Gretzky once said that you miss 100% of the shots you don't take. This is kind of the converse. This is saying you speed up 100% of the computations that you don't make. So here's the memo decorator. The guts of it is the same as what I sketched out previously. If we haven't computed the result already, we compute the result by applying the function f to the arguments. It gives us a result. We cache that result away. Then we return it for this time, and it's ready for next time. Next time we come through, we try to look up the arguments in the cache to see if they're there. If they are, we return the result. And now I've decided to structure this one as a try except statement rather than an if-then statement. And in Python, you always have two choices. You can first ask for permission to say, are the args in the cache? And if so, return cache or args. Or you can use a try except pattern to ask for forgiveness afterwards, to say, I'm first going to try to say, if the args are in the cache, go ahead and return it. If I get a key error, then I have to fill in the cache by doing the computation and then returning the result. And the reason I use the try structure here rather than the if structure is because I knew I was going to need it anyways for this third case. Either the args are in the cache or they aren't, but then there's this third case, which says that the args are not even hashable. And what does that mean? Start out with the dictionary d being empty, and then I'm going to have a variable x, and let's say x is a number. If I now ask, is x in d? That's going to tell me false, it's not in the dictionary yet. But now, let's say I have another variable, which is y, which is the list 1, 2, 3, and now if I ask, is y in d? You'd think that that would tell me false, but in fact, it doesn't. Instead, it gives me an error, and what it's going to tell me is type error, unhashable type list. What does that mean? So that means we were trying to look up y in the dictionary, and a dictionary is a hash table. It's implemented as a hash table. And in order to do that, we have to compute the hash code for y and then look in that slot in the dictionary. But this error is telling us that there is no hash code for a list. And why do you think that is? Are lists unhashable because lists can be arbitrarily long, or because lists can hold any type of data as the elements, not just integers, or because lists are mutable? Now, I recognize this might be a hard problem. If you're not up on hash tables, this might not be a question you can answer, but give it a shot and give me your one best response.